Hi, in this video we can take a look into the most commonly used HDFS commands. So these are the commands that we use to interact with HDFS file system. So the commands almost looks similar to the Unix commands, also behave in almost in the same manner that Unix commands work. Okay, so let me start this one by one. So there are around 20 plus commands that we are going to discuss here, and I will demonstrate these commands with the help of some sample exercise. So the first command we are going to check is mkdir. So as we know, the mkdir command in Linux, so this command is used for creating a directory. Okay, and there are a lot of options with this command, and we are using the same, I mean, mkdir command how we use in HDFS. I will show. So for that you need to use HDFS DFS hyphen mkdir, and where you want to create. So I'm creating under slash user and the directory as abc. Okay, so this is a simple command which I am going to use. So this will create a directory. Okay, so I think this already exists. Then let me create one test dir. Okay, so that is created. So let me check the content here. So under slash user we can see one directory, test dir, created here, right? So this is the directory, and I used HDFS user, that is a super user, to do that. So it got super user privilege. So ownership and group and ownership is from super user. And suppose if I want to create a directory like this. Okay, so let me show training, then under training ABC, under that DEF. See, if you want to create a directory something like this, so if you try this, so definitely it will fail, like saying this directory does not exist, right? So why? Because it is trying to create a directory def under slash user slash training abc. Suppose if you want to override this, and if you want to create, so first you have to create a directory under slash user with the name training, and inside that one directory abc, and inside that def. So if you want to do everything in a single stretch, you can use hyphen pre flag. So that will create these directories one by one. So first to create a directory training, and inside that def. So if I check this under user, I can see that training directory will be there, and under that abc will be there, and inside that, see, the training is here. And if I use this, I can see abc also def inside that. So this is how mkdir command works. So mkdir is used for creating a directory inside, and before executing, so you need to make sure, so whatever the user you are doing will have the right access on inside this directory, parent directory, where you are executing that command. So next command we are going to check is ls. So as we have seen, ls is used for listing files and directories. Suppose I want to list whatever the files and directories inside this, so I can use hdfs dfs hyphen ls slash user training. So that will list all the files and directories inside this. I think inside that there is not much files and directories, so only displaying that, right? So this is another directory, and I am checking that what are the contents inside that. So this will list all the files and directories. You can see the first part is something like the permission, the second is the replication factor, and this is the user and group, then this is the size and the timestamp and the directory name. So ls will list. Suppose if you want to list everything in a recursive manner, actually this is a directory, right? D. So inside that there are some more files. If you want to list that also, you can use hyphen r flag. So this will list everything in a recursive manner. So even inside that directory, so what are the contents, it will list that as well. So this is about the recursive listing. So just use hyphen r flag. So if you have directories inside a directory and there are multiple files inside that, and if you want to list that, you can use hyphen r flag. Okay, so next command which I am going to explain here is chown, changing the ownership. So you can just check hdfs dfs hyphen ls slash user, and there are a lot of directories, and we have created one directory training some time back, and if you look that it is owned by this HDFS user and group is HDFS. So I'm changing this ownership, so I can use that HDFS DFS hyphen change on. So I have one user and I'm changing the ownership of this directory to this user, and if you check this command again, so you can see this HDFS is changed to my username. See, and if you check the contents inside that HDFS DFS hyphen LS and see that contents, so these inside the directories are still owned by this HDFS user. Why? Because we just use the chown, so that will be changing the ownership of this peripheral directory alone. Whatever the inside contents are, still using the same permission. So if you want to change that, I mean, so that everything, even including it's inside the directories or inside file, everything, if you want to change the permission, just use, sorry, change the ownership, use r flag. So this will recursively change everything inside this directory. So now if I check this one, so inside that, so this will be, instead of HDFS, this will be changed to my username, right? So this also, even in inside that, whatever the inside directories also, or directories or file, whatever it may be, change that ownership. So this is how chown works. So chown command is used for changing the ownership. Similarly, there is a concept of group. Okay, so the group is on, now it is owned by HDFS group. So I'm just changing that there is a group for this user. So that is HAAdmin. So I'm changing the group of this directory to HAAdmin. So I can use HDFS DFS hyphen CH group. Then HAAdmin. Then this directory. So I can change the group membership is changed to HAAdmin. I can check here. Yes, this is changed, but inside the group privilege may not be changed. So to make that changes, to reflect that changes to happen inside also, I need to use the flag hyphen r, right? So here I can use hyphen r flag so that it recursively change the group. Right, so this is how this works. So if I check inside that, whatever the inside directory is also changed, and the group membership is changed to whatever the new group I have given. So this is how we can use chgrp. So this is used for changing the group. Use hyphen r flag if you want to do it in a recursive way. So recursive way is nothing like, so go inside the directories and whatever the files and directories inside, so that will, it will change the group or ownership of that also. So this is how chgrp, so change group command, works. So next we will see how to change the permission. So we have seen how to change the ownership and group. So this is the permission part. So this will be similar to, this is almost similar to the Unix permission. So we can use the number like 4 for read, 2 for write, and 1 for execute, and that pattern, and for that 3 digit permission bit we can set by using chmod. Okay, See, okay, so in my case, so this is read, write, execute for user, I mean, who are the owner, and read and execute for group members, and for others, read and execute. So suppose I don't want this and I want to change to, so for others, I don't want any permission. So I can, what I can use is HDFS, DFS, hyphen chmod. So I need to find out this permission bits. Okay, so for read, write, execute together, so I, this is a 7, that means 4 plus 2 plus 1. I have a video on Unix permission numbering, so please watch that, so if you are already not familiar with this numbering sequence. And for write and read and execute, 4 plus 2, 6, and no permission means 7. So use this one. Okay, so if you want to apply it in a recursive way, hyphen R flag you can use. So chmod is for changing the permission. So you, if you have the permission number in your hand, you can apply that. And if you use this one, so we can see it's like this one. After that, there is no permission bit. I mean, for others, there is no permission set. Right. So read and execute. I just need read and execute only. No write permission for group members. So I can change this permission bit by using the chmod. So this hyphen R is for recursive way. So if I'm not using hyphen R, so it will change the permission for outside directories or directory only. Right. So read and execute. So this way we can use chmod command to change the permission. So we have seen like mkdir command for creating a directory, then ls command for listing files and directories, then changing the ownership using chown command, and changing the group chgrp, and chmod command for changing the permission. So we will see some more commands on the file system, and I will be covering those in my next video. So please keep watching, and thank you. Bye.